MyHeritage, is it good? Is it bad? Well, as with most things in life, there's some of each. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. I'm continuing on in my reviews of different testing companies, and today I want to talk about MyHeritage and what I like about MyHeritage and what I don't like about MyHeritage when it comes to DNA testing. Now let me start by prefacing and saying I haven't actually taken the MyHeritage DNA test. What I have done is I have transferred over my 23andMe DNA test results to MyHeritage, and I actually did this when MyHeritage and 23andMe had a partnership together. So with that introduction, let's get into the things I like about MyHeritage. Number one, free uploading of your DNA kits from other companies. This is fantastic. Now, MyHeritage is doing this to help build up their database, but it also allows you to try out their tools before you've even bought their kit. So I think it's a wonderful thing that they're doing there. Number two, is the ability to manage multiple kits. And I've pointed this out as a positive on 23andMe, and I've pointed it out as a negative on Ancestry. So what I like about being able to manage multiple kits is then I don't have to log in to multiple different accounts to be able to get all of the matching information. I can just switch between which kit that I'm looking at to see the different matches for that. And that is what I like about managing multiple kits. And MyHeritage has that. So good job on that, MyHeritage. Number three, the ability to link your DNA to your tree. This is a really powerful tool because it allows the computer to find matches for you on your DNA, but then search through both of your trees to see if there is a common ancestor that you both have. Now, this doesn't always mean that that ancestor is who you inherited that DNA from, but it is a great tool to help you get started in your matching and finding other people and how you might be related to them. So those are three things that I really like about the MyHeritage DNA database. But as with everything, there are some things I don't like about it. And what are those? Number one, it is a small database. MyHeritage came to the game late. Originally, they were partnered with 23andMe, and you had a genealogy company, and you had a, I guess you could say, a tree and a record genealogy company combined together, which I thought was an awesome partnership. However, MyHeritage wanted to get into the genetic genealogy themselves, and so that partnership was severed, and they've been in the process of building their own database. And so it's really small, and you can tell that just by the number of matches that you have. Most people that I've talked to have on the order of 50 to maybe 200 matches total on MyHeritage, whereas if you go to 23andMe or Family Tree DNA, you're going to have 1,000 or 2,000 matches, and if you go to Ancestry, you're going to have several thousand matches, and that's just because of the size of the database. The small database, it makes finding matches very difficult. That's one thing, though, that MyHeritage is doing their best to try to increase by allowing people to upload and also by having sales of their different kits. So I expect their database to grow in the future, but right now, from a genealogical standpoint, it's not as useful just because it's so small. Number two of the things that I don't like is they don't have a chromosome browser. I mentioned before that this is a really important tool for evaluating your matches. You want to actually see what segments you share in common, not just with one person, but with multiple people, in order to do triangulation. So the fact that they don't have a chromosome browser is a big negative. They do tell you some information about how much DNA you share and how many segments, but they don't tell you detailed information about that. And so if you're using MyHeritage DNA for that, you're going to need to download that and take that over to GEDmatch.com in order to see that segment information for your different matches. And number three, because they're the newest company on the block, they really have a limited tool set. Other than telling you that you have matches, there's not much else that they're going to be able to tell you that you can do with your DNA on MyHeritage. This may be something that as they develop it further, they add more tools, but right now it's a big negative because there's several different things that you may want to do with your information in order to evaluate your different matches, and MyHeritage just does not have the tools to be able to do that with. So if you do test through MyHeritage DNA, make sure you're uploading your results over to GEDmatch.com so that you can take advantage of the tools that they have to properly evaluate the DNA information that you get. Like I've mentioned a couple times, MyHeritage is the newest of the genealogical companies that is getting into DNA testing. Some of these negatives might be going away over the next year or two as they increase the size of their database, as they increase their tool set, as they invest in this technology. So I have a lot of hope for the future potential of what MyHeritage DNA has. I hope this review of MyHeritage DNA was helpful to you. Please put any comments down below if you like MyHeritage and what it is that you like about them. And if there's things that you don't like about them, make sure you put those in the comments as well.
If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so that it can reach more viewers. Connect with us on Twitter at FH Fanatics or on Facebook, Family History Fanatics, where we can interact with you and respond to your comments.